for this shit, nigga. Might go down for this shit. What up, y'all? This that Dirty Toothpaste. Like, comment, and subscribe, please. I need those. I'm a new channel, and I'm trying to pop out here in this YouTube world. Check it. Today, I'm going to talk to you about this guy right here. I don't even want to say his name. It leave a bad taste in my mouth. No whole meals. All right, now check it out. This is the thing. People are paying attention to this clown. And they talking about, oh, he's this, he's that, he told on this one, he took that one away from his family, yet y'all out here talking about, dude, like, why are y'all trying to play the role? This be the problem with a lot of these sites and these people that's in the game. One of them being Vlad. Two of them, DJ Ghost. Man, what hurt my heart was DJ Ghost. I expect Vlad to do this type of shit. But when you listen to other shit, because, like, I block both of them on YouTube as far as them trying to come down my, I forgot what you call that shit, man. But you know when you scroll down, I don't want to see them no more. Now, with Vlad, he a vulture. Like, I already get it, man. But it's just certain narratives that's in the black community that he has consistently, lately, try to control what's being said about it. The first thing that set me, the shit had me tight, was Dr. Sebi. If you haven't researched that man and you don't know nothing about him, then shut up. Shut up. Shut your face. But he got this white is better mentality. And it's hard for him not to have it. That's just what it is. Western medicine is better. Like, everything is better if it's white, right? DJ Ghost was another one that I saw talking about how crazy it was, what he did, this, that, and the third. I'm going down, scrolling down my mentions, or not even mentions, but whatever my timeline or whatever YouTube is being called, and I see DJ Ghost reacting to the video. Like, bro, like, you got to stand on what you do. And, like, if you was a smaller channel, it'll be one thing. But y'all kind of husky out here. So you're helping this kid, like, regardless of what you say. So he not only does a reaction video for his new music, he does a reaction video for when this gets online, because y'all know I'm trying not to curse. I'm trying. Damn it, I'm trying. When this bird, N-word, gets on Instagram Live and you do a reaction video to that. Like, first of all, we took a hit. Like, hip-hop as a whole. Like, and hip-hop and black people. Because we let these people, like, that's a white boy. Period, point blank. You let a white boy come into the non-trade gangsters and fuck.
That's crazy!
Excuse my friends, I tried, I'm trying. But he came into the game and came into the gang and messed everything up. Why? Because y'all mess with anybody. And when I say that, I'm not talking to non-trades. This is not a non-trade problem. That's a black problem. Because if you notice, Beyonce couldn't go to the Country Music Awards. They wasn't letting her rock. But as soon as we get a Post Malone.
Bruh.
Tekashi. He's white. He's a white Mexican. For y'all who don't know, because I know I'm going to have idiots talking about, oh, he's Mexican. He's a white Mexican. You have black Mexicans. You have black Dominicans, even though they don't like being called black, even when they darker than the darkest African from Zamunda. But the bottom line is this. You have white Mexicans. You have black Mexicans. You have white Brazilians. You have black Brazilians. Tekashi's white. So you let the white boy come in the game and mess everything up. He used y'all. That's just what it is. And then we got this thing called HR 66 out running around where these white people done created a law.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I had to go for a second. Did you people hear that? That was crazy. My wife came in the house. My dog almost gave me a heart attack out here. I left it because she said it was funny. She said I should leave it. All right, anyway, let's get back to it. Now, these white people have created a law where they can basically come up in the crib because they suspect that you have COVID-19. Now, basically, when they write a law that vague, it's basically saying, your next door neighbor could have said that you coughed. And under suspicion that you have COVID-19, we're going to come snatch you up out of here. When you look at the things that's been going on recently in black neighborhoods, they're going upside people's heads just for being together. In white neighborhoods, they're giving away masks. They locked a white woman up for being in the park when she wasn't supposed to. They treated her like Rosa Parks. She's the white female Martin Luther King right now. They're paying the legal fees and everything. Black people are getting assaulted, beat upside the head out here like it's a game. So I'm trying to figure out what's going on. Matter of fact, I'm not trying to figure out what's going on. I know what's going on. I'm trying to figure out when our people are going to be like, yo, this shit. Man, nope. I'll take care of it. And I'm not gonna leave that in there, but that's just how I feel right now. Sheesh, they killing us left and right. Brother was out there jogging. What happens? They try to make an excuse that he was looking at some property. The property is not lived in. The owners of it that are selling it, or either it's construction, one of the two is going on. They said that he wasn't doing anything. There's cameras on the premises. So if the owners say he wasn't doing anything, what kind of narrative are people trying to create? Come on, man. And when it come to the Tekashi dude, why would we care what he's doing unless they're scraping his mental off of a wall? Who cares? He's a piece of crap. He did crimes. He put hits on people, paid for it. But yet the people that were protecting him are all in prison? And he's out running around, daring people to touch him yet once again. This is the law system, or the system we supposed to respect, right? When you got people out here that can rock like him, I don't care how you look at it, the boy beat the system. And he was doing some crazy stuff. But everybody that was dark, look at him. Look what happened to Bobby Smurda. So, mind yours, and I'm not trying to hear none of that when it comes to the white boy. That's the bottom line out here. This is that dirty toothpaste. I'm not going to tell you to be careful. I will tell you don't get caught. Like, comment, and subscribe. I'm out of here. Thank you.
We might die for this shit, nigga. Might go down for this shit, nigga. That gang banging that crip shit. We might die for this shit, nigga. Might go down for this shit, nigga. That gang banging that crip shit. We might die for this shit, nigga. Might go down for this shit, nigga. That gang banging that crip shit. We might die for this shit, nigga.